Hello children, I welcome you all for the today's session. Today we are going to see the continuation of chapter 4 part 3 and 4 from our textbook Honeydew. The title of the lesson is Bipin Chowdhury's Lapse of Memory, written by Satyajit Ray. This chapter was divided into four parts. So far we have completed part 1 and 2. In this session we are going to see part 3 and 4. To motivate you, let me show you a video clip for part 3 and 4. Keep watching.
Bipin almost thought he was losing his mind. He felt even worse when his friend Dinesh Mukherjee confirmed that they had visited Ranchi in October 1958. Bipin felt terribly upset, wondering how he could forget only one incident but remember everything else. As he lay down to rest, Bipin's schoolmate Chunni Lal dropped by for a visit. Chunni Lal wanted Bipin to help him find a job, so he kept coming to Bipin again and again. Bipin had told Chunni Lal many times that he was unable to help him. However, Bipin decided to meet Chunni Lal and ask him whether he remembered anything about Bipin's visit to Ranchi. Chunni Lal was amazed to find that Bipin could not remember having visited Ranchi in October 1958. Feeling extremely worried, Bipin called for a doctor who advised him to visit Ranchi. Bipin went to Ranchi and to Hoodroo Falls, but he did not find any of it familiar. This made him feel worse and he fainted. When he regained consciousness, Bipin was convinced he would lose his willpower, desire to work and his sanity. When he returned to Calcutta, he received a letter. It was from Chunni Lal. Chunni Lal had written that the prank was his way of getting back at Bipin because wealth and power had changed him. Because Bipin did not help Chunni Lal, Chunni Lal decided to use his imagination to push Bipin with a story that was a complete lie.
Before we begin with part 3, let's have a quick recap of what we have read in the story so far. Bipin Babu was very shy and introvert person, but very fond of books. And every Monday he used to go to New Market at Kalicharan's shop to buy some books. And one day he met a man called Parimal Ghosh. Now Bipin did not recognize Parimal Ghosh as his acquaintance. Acquaintance means familiarity. But Parimal Ghosh gave his details of his Ranchi trip in October 1958. Bipin was confused because he knew that he never been to Ranchi. Yet this man, whom he did not know, knew so much about him and his personal life. He thought of confirming it from his friend Dinesh Mukherjee. When he called up Dinesh, he also confirmed that Bipin had been to Ranchi in October 1958. But Bipin Babu knew very well that in October 1958, he had been to Kanpur at one of his friends to celebrate Puja festival there. Yet, he was not sure whether the things that was going on in his life were really okay or not. He started to suspect, did he have any problem with his mind? Was he undergoing any memory loss? He was completely shocked and confused and just him know what to do. Now after this, let's read in part 3 what happens next in the story. After lunchtime, Bipin Babu realized that he couldn't possibly carry on. Carry on means continue sitting at his desk and working. This had never happened in the 25 years he had been with the firm. He had a reputation for being a tireless, conscientious worker. Conscientious means careful and correct. But today his head was in a whirl. His head was in a whirl is a idiom, means confused and unable to think clearly. Back home at 2:30, Bipin Babu lay down in bed and tried to gather his wits together. To gather his wits together, which means make an effort to become calm and think clearly. He knew that it was possible to lose one's memory through an injury in the head, but he did not know a single instant of someone remembering everything except one particular incident, and a fairly recent and significant. Significant means important one at that. He had also wanted to go to Ranchi to have gone through, done things, and not to remember was something utterly impossible. Utterly means totally impossible. At 7:30, Bipin Babu's servant came and announced, "Chuni Babu, sir, says it's very important." Bipin Babu knew what Chuni had come for. Chunilal had been at school with him. He didn't been having a rough time lately. Having a rough time lately means having a lot of problems recently, and had been coming to see him about a job. Bipin Babu knew it was not possible to do anything for him, and in fact told him so. But Chuni kept turning up like a bad penny. Kept turning up like a bad penny, which means appearing at a place where one is not welcome. Bipin Babu sent word that not only was it not possible for him to see Chuni now, but not in several weeks. So here, Bipin Babu was avoiding Chunilal for several weeks. But as soon as the servant stepped out of the room, it struck Bipin Babu that Chuni might remember something about the 58 trip. 58, that means in the year 1958. That was the trip to Ranchi. There was no harm in asking him. Bipin Babu hurried down the stairs and into the living room. Chuni was about to leave, but seeing Bipin Babu appear, he turned round hopefully. Bipin Babu didn't beat about the bush. Didn't beat about the bush, which means it's idiom, which means came straight to the point. So he started asking the same point immediately. "Listen, Chuni, I want to ask you something. You have a good memory and you have been seeing me off and on. Off and on means now and then. For a long time. Just throw your mind back, which means recall the think back and recall the past event. And tell me, did you go to Ranchi in 58? Chuni said, "58? It must have been 58, or was it 59? Let's see the explanation of these paragraphs. After lunchtime, Bipin Babu realized that he couldn't possible carry on means continue for sitting in a place and working, because he continuously thinking about those Ranchi trip and about the person Chunilal. This had never happened in the 25 years of his lifetime. He had been with the firm. Firm means confident, and he had a reputation for being a He was tireless and very careful worker, and everybody respected him. But for the first time in these 25 years, it had happened with him that he couldn't concentrate on the work. Obviously, because whatever Parimal Ghosh and Dinesh Mukherjee and everyone had told him that he had been to Ranchi was disturbing him constantly. Although he knew that he had been, yet now he became doubtful about him and his memory. And he had been looking at Bipin Babu to help him. But Bipin knew that nothing could be done. That's why lately he had been trying to avoid Chunilal. So Bipin Babu told his servant to tell Chunilal that he wouldn't be meet right now. And the servant left the room to tell this message to Chunilal. It struck to Bipin Babu, why not ask Chunilal about his Ranchi trip in the year 1958. So he hurried downstairs to talk to Chunilal. Now let's see the next passages in part 3, that what Chunilal answers. Chuni said, 58? It must have been 58, or was it 59? You're sure that I did go to Ranchi? Bipin asked. Chuni look at amazement was not mixed with worry. Amazement was not mixed with worry, which means surprised or worried. Do you mean you have any doubts about having gone at all? Asked Chunilal. Did I go? Do you remember clearly? Said Bipin. Chuni sat down on the sofa, fixed Bipin Babu with a long, hard stare and said, Bipin, have you taken to drugs or something? As far as I know, you had a clean record for such things were concerned. I know that old friendships don't mean much to you, but at least you had a good memory. You can't really mean that you have forgotten about the Ranchi trip? Bipin Babu had to turn away from Chuni's incredulous stare. Incredulous means unbelieving. Do you remember what my last job was? Asked Chunilal. Of course, worked in a travel agency. You remember that? And you don't remember that. It was I who fixed up your railway booking for Ranchi. I went to the station to see you off. One of the fans in your compartment was not working. I got an electrician to fix it. Have you forgotten everything? Whatever is the matter with you, you don't look too well, you know. Bipin shied and shook his head. I have been working too hard, he said at last. That must be the reason. Must see about consulting a specialist. Must see about consulting? It's an idiom, which means may have to consult. Doubtless, it was Bipin's condition which made Chunilal leave without mentioning anything about a job. Let's see the explanation of these paragraphs. Bipin Babu was doubly shocked when Chunilal was confirmed that he had been to Ranchi. When Bipin Babu asked him, did he really remember that? Chunilal answered that he was working in a travel agency that time, and he was one who arranged Bipin Babu's Ranchi ticket and also got the fan repaired in the compartment. Bipin Babu did not know what to do. He was speechless, and at that Chunilal advised him to go to a doctor and to get himself treated. On seeing Bipin Babu's bad condition, Chunilal did not speak a word about a job and left the place quietly. Let's see what happens next. Paresh Chanda was a young physician with a pair of bright eyes and a sharp nose. he became thoughtful when he heard about Bipin's symptoms. "Look, Dr. Chanda," said Bipin Babu desperately, "you must cure me of this horrible illness. I can't tell you how it's affecting my work." Dr. Chanda shook his head. "You know what, Mr. Chaudhary," he said, "I have never had to deal with such a case as yours. Frankly, this is quite outside my field of experience. But I have one suggestion. I don't know if it'll work, but it's worth a try. It can do no harm." Bipin Babu leaned forward anxiously. Leaned means bent or and anxiously means nervously. "As far as I can make out," said Dr. Chanda, "and I think you are of the same opinion, you must have been to Ranchi, but due to some unknown reason, the entire episode has slipped out of your mind. What I suggest is that you go to Ranchi once again. The sight of the place may remind you of your trip. This is not impossible. More than that, I cannot do at the moment. I am prescribing a nerve tonic." Prescribing means advising. A nerve tonic and a tranquilizer. Tranquilizer means a medicine to reduce stress and anxiety. Sleep is essential or the symptoms will get more pronounced. Pronounced means strong. Bipin Babu felt somewhat better the next morning. After breakfast, he rang up his office, gave some instructions, and then procured a first-class ticket. Procured means got with a little difficulty a first-class ticket for Ranchi for the same evening. Let's see the explanation of these paragraphs. After being advised by Chunilal to consult a doctor, Bipin Babu went to Dr. Paresh Chanda. Now, Paresh Chanda was a physician. Physician means doctor. But he had never encountered a case like that of Bipin Babu's. So, he prescribed a nerve tonic and a tranquilizer so that Bipin Babu will be able to sleep and be peaceful. He also advised Bipin Babu to go back to Ranchi and see if he can recall a few things of that place. Bipin Babu slept that night and the next morning he was feeling little better because of the medication, but instantly he booked a ticket for Ranchi and left for Ranchi in the evening. Now let's start to read part 4 of the chapter. This part was deal with what happened to him when he was in Ranchi. How did he feel and what conclusion did he come out at the end of the story? Let's begin to read this part. Getting off the train at Ranchi next morning, he realized at once that he had never been there before. He came out of the station, took a taxi and drove around the town for a while. He realized that the streets, the buildings, the hotels, the bazaars and the Morabadi hills, with none of these he had slightest acquaintance. Acquaintance means familiarity or being familiar. Would a trip to the Hudru Falls help? He didn't believe so, but at the same time, he didn't wish to leave with the feeling that he hadn't tried enough. So, he arranged for a car and left for Hudru in the afternoon. At 5 o'clock, the same afternoon in Hudru, two Gujarati gentlemen from a group of picnickers, picnickers means people who go on picnics, discovered Bipin Babu lying unconscious. Unconscious is in an unawake state beside a boulder. Boulder means a big rock. When he came round means regain consciousness. The first thing Bipin Babu said was, "I am finished. There's no hope left." Next morning, Bipin Babu was back in Kolkata. He realized that there was truly no hope for him. Soon, he would lose everything, such as his will to work, his confidence, his ability, his balance of mind. Was he going to end up in asylum at? Bipin Babu couldn't think anymore. Asylum. Asylum means shelter. Back home, he rang up Dr. Chanda and asked him to come over. Then, after a shower, he got into the bed with an ice bag clamped. Clamped means fixed on his head. Just then, the servant brought him a letter which someone had left in the letterbox. It was a greenish envelope with his name in red ink on it. Let's see the explanation of these paragraphs. On Dr. Paresh Chandra's advice, he went to Ranchi. When he looked out of the window, out of the taxi, he tried to recall the buildings, the roads, the bazaars, the area where all he had gone. But he found all of them were very unfamiliar to him. Then he thought of going to Hudru Falls and believed that he might recall something about those falls. When he went there, after a while, he fell unconscious. When two of the picnickers found him lying unconscious there, they tried to help him to gain consciousness. On coming round, he said, "There was just no hope." Next day morning, he was back in Kolkata, but a very stressed out mind. He was depressed because he thought, now there is no hope. Something has happened to him, probably a kind of memory loss, or now what would become of him? He'll end up losing his job, his confidence, his ability, and his respect in the society. He might end up in an asylum where he'll die and no one will even look after him. He didn't know what to do. Completely depressed, he called up the doctor, Paresh Chanda, and told him to come over to meet him. Just then, the servant got a letter. It was in a greenish envelope. Children, let's see what was there in the letter. Above the name, it said urgent and confidential. Confidential means private. In spite of his condition, Bipin Babu had a feeling that he ought to go through the letter. He tore open the envelope and took out the letter. This is what he read. "Dear Bipin, I had no idea that affluence means wealth, would bring about the kind of change in you that it has done. Was it so difficult for you to help out an old friend down on his luck?" Down on his luck. It's an idiom which means experiencing bad luck. "I have no money, so my resources are limited. What I have is my imagination, a part of which I used in retribution of your unfeeling behavior." Here, "in retribution of" means as a punishment for. Unfeeling means uncaring behavior. "Well, you'll be all right again now. A novel I have written is being considered by a publisher. If he likes it enough, it'll see me through the next few months. Yours, Chunilal." When Dr. Chanda came, Bipin Babu said, "I'm fine." It all came back as soon as I got off the train at Ranchi. "A unique case," said Dr. Chanda. "I shall certainly write about it in a medical journal." Journal means a magazine on a specific subject. "The reason why I sent for you," said Bipin Babu. "Sent for you" means called you, "is that I have a pain in the hip from the fall I had in Ranchi. If you could prescribe a painkiller.
Let's see the explanation of these paragraphs.
Bipin Babu tore open the envelope, and that was a letter from Chunilal, wherein he had written, "Dear Bipin Babu, I had no idea that wealth could change you so much. When I was under bad condition or undergoing bad luck, you didn't help me with the job. I have no money, but I have imagined. So, whatever you have undergone or whatever you have just experienced about the Ranchi trip is all a part of my imagination. And this was that to punish you off your misbehavior. In some time, you will be all right, and I have written a novel which is now considered by a publisher, and maybe I'll get some money to see me through a few months from here." When Bipin Babu read this letter, he couldn't believe his eyes. He now understood that this was all trick that was played by his very own friend Chunilal. And why do you think that Chunilal must play a trick on him? Because Bipin Babu refused to help him when he required it. So Chunilal was so anguished and was so frustrated that he desired to punish Bipin Babu, and he had created such an environment which Bipin Babu would get stressed and would feel depressed about his mental condition. But what could be done? Now Bipin Babu learnt his lesson, and as he was thinking about all this, Paresh Chanda entered into the room. But Bipin Babu felt so embraced that he couldn't tell the doctor that what the real case was. So he just told him that he had a fall due to which his hip was paining. So to cover up, Bipin Babu could only ask for a few painkillers for that hip pain. So children, that's the end of the story. What do you learn from it? This was an interesting story, and the suspense was out only at the end of the entire story. We kept on believing that there must be something wrong with Bipin Babu and his mental condition was degrading. But at the end, we realized that nothing was like that. It was just a punishment which he got from a friend whom he did not help. So the moral of the story is that whenever a person is in need, we must help that person. Because as they say, a friend in need is a friend indeed. So children, in the first session of this chapter, we completed part 1 and 2. This is the second session. In this second session, we completed the next parts, that is 3 and 4. Part 3 and part 4 of this chapter. Chapter 4, Prose, Bipin Chowdhury's Lapse of Memory, written by Satyajit Ray. So, please read the story from the textbook, understand the story, then learn the question answers given, write the classwork neatly, and send your classwork photocopy through Teachmint.